Although I myself have grounds for confidence, even in the flesh. If anyone else thinks he can be confident in flesh, all the more can I. Circumcised on the eighth day of the race of Israel, of the tribe of Benjamin, a Hebrew of Hebrew parentage, in observance of the law, a Pharisee. In zeal, I persecuted the church. In righteousness, based on the law, I was blameless. But whatever gains I had, these I have come to consider a loss because of Christ. More than that, I even consider everything as a loss because of the supreme good of knowing Christ Jesus, our Lord. The word of the Lord. Let the hearts rejoice who search for the Lord. Sing to him, sing his praise, proclaim all his wondrous deeds. Glory in his holy name. Rejoice, O hearts that seek the Lord. Let the hearts rejoice. Look to the Lord in his strength. Seek to serve him constantly. Recall the wondrous deeds that he has wrought, his portents and the judgments he has uttered. Let hearts rejoice. You descendants of Abraham, his servants, sons of Jacob, his chosen ones, he, the Lord, is our God. Throughout the earth, his judgments prevail. Let hearts rejoice.
Rejoice with me, because I have found the coin that I have lost. Just the same way, I tell you, there will be rejoicing among the angels of God over one sinner who repents. The Gospel of the Lord.
The shepherd left 99 sheep to seek the lost one. These are those who have no need of repentance. Here, Jesus is speaking with a sense of irony, since we are all in need of conversion. While we may be in the fold of the church, our conversion remains an ongoing process. However, it is a real danger to begin to think of oneself as fully converted, or as having arrived at moral perfection. This seems to be Christ's point in another passage where a Pharisee prayed, "O God, I thank you. I am not like the rest of humanity, greedy, dishonest, adulterous, or even like this tax collector. I fast twice a week and I pay tithes on my whole income." But the tax collector stood off at a distance and would not even raise his eyes to heaven, and beat his breast and prayed, "O God, be merciful to me, a sinner." It was the tax collector who went home justified. Who am I? A Pharisee or a tax collector? With confidence, let us offer our prayers to our Father in heaven.
For leaders of the church, may the Holy Spirit work through them in seeking the lost and welcoming the outcast. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our national and local leaders, may they be blessed with the compassion of Christ in their attentiveness to the needs of the most vulnerable, especially the unborn. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, especially those struggling with chronic illness, may God bring them healing of mind and body. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this worship community, may God help us grow in faith and in appreciation of the unique gifts in one another. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died, may they be welcomed into the heavenly kingdom by the communion of saints. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all those special intentions that we keep in the silence of our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, we entrust our prayers to you in the holy name of your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives forever and ever.
mystery of faith, save us, Savior of the world.
Right.
For by your cross and resurrection,
you
have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered forth by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, from the world, and bring it to the fullness of charity, together with Francis of Hope, our name of Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also, brothers and sisters, who fall asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, and we pray that in the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed Joseph, his spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may be written to us to eternal life, and we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
As a disciple of Jesus, who need repentance, let us pray to our Father to forgive our sins. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Grace us in grand peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, we said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in the heart of the world. Live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let us all give each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter
my room,
but only say the
word, and my soul shall be healed.
Communion prayer. You will show me the path of life, the fullness of joy in your presence, O Lord.
Thank you.
act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.